Hey Lawrence,
What's going on?
what's going on? Chess is going on, football's
There
going
is.
on.
Yeah.
Loads of things, loads of nice
Well,
things.
actually, since the last time we spoke, we beat you guys, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. We haven't spoken about that, right?
We
Since.
have spoken. Did we spoke about that? I was upset that you beat us, and now it turns out England is in the finals. It's
Yeah, we are in the finals.
pretty cool. I mean, that is it really the first time in the Euro that ever happened before for England? I think
Yes,
so, right?
or rather, maybe no. I think we got to the European Championship Finals in like 1960 something. Not the World Cup, the European. But we haven't been in a final since I've been alive. That's the point.
That's the point.
So it's quite a big deal if you're English.
So what are you doing this Sunday? Are you going to
Unclear.
Okay.
Unclear yet where I'm going to watch it. If I'm going to watch it at home, if I'm going to go to a bar and watch it. I was thinking, should I go to an Italian restaurant, sit among the Italians? That would be good fun, but
Indeed.
no,
Unclear. So
I don't know yet.
what's your prediction though?
I think we're going to win it. I think it's fate. I think it's coming home, as the song says.
Oh my God.
And it's being played at Wembley. They're going to be super energized. And I haven't been the Italians have had some good players. Chiesa has been very, very impressive to
Yeah.
me. Chiesa, who, by the way, is the son of
Enrico.
Enrico, who I used to watch play for Parma Sampdoria in the Italian league in the 90s when I was growing up.
And
Yeah.
back then he was a killer
And
already.
he was fantastic. He was a fantastic player. Now his son is playing fantastic. It's going to be a it's going to be a tie. I mean, it's going to be a really close game. No, I mean, it's going to be a tough game. But I think we're going to do it. I think just you know what? I think we've got a lot of pace. I don't think they deal that well with the pace. They've got an old defense, Chiellini and these guys. I think Sterling is going to cause them problems. Saka is going to cause them problems. Grealish, when he comes on, will cause them problems. All of these guys. So I just think we're going to win it. I don't know when. I don't, but we will win it if it doesn't go to penalties. If it goes to penalties, I don't know. I mean, we're very bad at
That
penalties.
is interesting because I believe, and this is actually now this is nice we're talking about this because I think there is a correlance to chess. So
Correlation.
correlation, thank you. The terrible with German and English today. So yeah, pick your to whatever you want. Southgate has trained penalty shootouts with the
Yes.
team for months. He
Yes.
made it public.
Yes.
He was talking about that penalties is the thing which they weren't very good, and now they've been excessively training this. Okay, now there's one tiny negativity about the Harry Kane's penalty. It was the first and only penalty England had so far,
Yes.
right? So yeah, he kind of messed it up,
He
although
did. It was a terrible penalty, let's be
it was
honest.
a bad penalty, and
Yeah.
maybe I think that he got interrupted by the lasers. Even more than Schmeichel himself,
Well, yeah.
maybe.
Yeah.
So, but yeah. So, but I believe that if it's gonna be penalty, then England is gonna take it, actually. But I believe
Interesting.
on the other hand, I also think that England will win 5-2 in regular time.
5-2.
5-2. It will be
You're
one goal in the
insane.
first 15 minutes, and then everything
Nuts.
will take its course, and then England will exceed with 4-0, think everything is relaxed, 4-1, 4-2, and then they will get the
Wow. I
last
hope.
goal in the 96th minute by I don't know, somebody.
I hope you're right.
That would be
I hope
great.
you're right. Yeah.
Wouldn't this be nice if chess games would be like this too, if you would go
Beautiful.
like, hey, the World Championship, it's a couple of months, and Magnus Carlsen will face Nepomniachtchi. And just imagine if you would lead with 4-0, the games would become much more open. But then you can try to play draw much more often in chess. If you're in super master class, it's so difficult to break something like
course
this,
it is.
especially when you're black. I guess in the situation when you're getting into the early lead, it's not like back then. I remember Kasparov Karpov, where Karpov was leading with 5-0 in the very beginning, and then Kasparov came back. I don't. Is it ever happening in the last years that there's like a
No.
big comeback? No, right?
No, because there are a fewer amount of games. So now there's only 12
Also,
games. So you can't go down 5-0. The match is just over. So
a very good
even one
point, yeah.
victory, even one victory is a big thing. Two victories and you're already a huge underdog.
And then, of course, that's why you play very safe and try to play like England against Germany. I criticized the game a bit, and yeah, I still do it a little because I really hope that there will be an early goal in the first 15 minutes and
Yeah, that would
then
be nice.
everything will take off. Please,
Yes.
otherwise it will stay 0-0 and it will be terrible. I hope
Yes,
not.
it would be. That would be
Anyway,
nice.
now that was all about the football game. We got this out of the system because it's the last game. Then we're done with that. Sorry for everybody who didn't enjoy football or doesn't enjoy football. Now it's time to talk about chess.
Yeah.
What do we have on the table? Please be my guest and
Well,
start.
I mean, we have a few things going on. Okay, we'll start with some very sad news that Yuri Dorkian, I mentioned this in my show, passed away. He was a famous coach. He was actually Kasparov's trainer. He passed away very young at the age of 58. 56,
56,
actually, I
isn't
think.
he?
Yeah, 56. Very, very premature because of Corona, obviously. You know, the Russian chess community is in shock. He also helped some of the big stars from the Russian teams. He was a coach of the national team. So that's a real sad story. Obviously, we won't dwell on that because it's
No,
a bit,
sure.
you know, it's a bit, it's horrible. But you know, rest in peace, Yuri Dogian, who was a tremendously important figure in the development of chess. And his efforts will be remembered. In more positive news, I mean, there are a few things that have happened this week. So I guess the first one, no big surprise. The Serbia Chess Open has been won by Nihal Sarin. You know, we've been speaking for weeks now about the rise of this crop of Indian young, talented geniuses. And they're
Talent.
not stopping. Nihal Sarin, who beat Kovalenko in round eight, then he only needed a draw and managed to get that and won the entire tournament with 7.5. This comes off his other win recently. This puts him over 2650 in the live ratings. So he's now top 100 players in the world.
He's the fifth best Indian player, as far as I know, yeah.
Yes, he's the fifth best Indian player. He's only 16 years old. You know, and as I you probably didn't see this, but I sent out a tweet,
I think I did.
which was it was quite funny.
I'm watching your
But
tweets though, because they're always a lot of fun to read.
yeah.
Oh yes, actually, of course, I remember. Yes, I saw your tweet. Of course, I saw that.
So I know Nihal. I've seen Nihal a lot. Before Corona, when I was a bit more active, I was playing in places like Gibraltar or in Spain, and Nihal was in a few tournaments I was playing, and he was a young kid, you know, with a, as I said in my tweet, with a fluffy mustache, and now he's like 2 foot taller, has a beard. That's how long it's been since I've seen him. And he's got another 100, 150 rating points as well. So well done to Nihal. And look at the other players as well. Look at this guy. We spoke about him. Arjun Eregyasi, yeah, played in this Magnus Carlsen Tour, scored a phenomenal 7 out of 7 points. I mean, 7 out of 9, he's gaining 11 points. He'll be well over 2600 soon. And then look at this guy, Aditya Mittal. I don't know him. Like an Indian IM. And actually, I think he made a Grandmaster Norm with this performance.
Sounds good to me.
Yes, I think he made a Norm
7 points
with
is.
this. Seven is definitely a Norm in this tournament.
And here, Pranov set on one position 113, and he became 26.
Yeah, I mean, this is the point. I mean, so whenever you play these open tournaments and you get a young Indian guy playing, you just hate your life because, you're playing somebody, you don't know if he's 2350, 2550. You know they're underrated and they're all chess addicts, and it's very, very tough. So doesn't surprise me at all. And look at some of the other top players that played in this tournament. I mean, you've got some real top players that played. If you look at this list,
Absolutely.
Kovalenko, Pishot, Shevchenko, Fedoseyev played there. I mean, just some real top players. So,
Even here, another super talent, Jonas Bjerre.
Jonas Bjerre from Denmark, obviously super young.
And who else played there? Our
Who?
my coach, Svitlana
Oh, she
Demchenko.
played.
Yeah, the only Canadian flag there, and she actually did quite well. I mean, look, she was set on position 277 of 280, basically, right? But she still could get catch 3 points. She wrote to me that she's a bit sad because all her drawn games, her four drawn games, she was in a winning position. And two were even like super clear. And yeah, but still, she's okay. She's fine. She got a couple of rating points. She thought she would lose them, but she says she has a lot of material for our upcoming coaching sessions. So yeah,
Ah,
well
good.
done for her. And now she's on her way to Sochi.
Now she's on her way to Sochi.
Yes, that's gonna happen next week. Yeah.
Yeah, it is. That's a big one, right? We'll talk about that more in the show next week, but it's the World Cup and it's huge
That's
tournament. It's
gonna be
going
a
to be
lot to talk about. Indeed,
huge.
absolutely. Yeah. Hope we can also maybe you can analyze one or another game like that.
Yeah, that would be
Yeah,
nice.
look at
Yeah.
this picture. It's so cute and
Yeah.
hilarious, right?
Yeah,
I
it's
mean.
just, but he's bigger than he used to be. That's the point, so
Exactly. Yes. You made a point there, and I really understand. Although all those guys, those two guys are just like, I don't know. I think they're 2 meter each. Like, or they just
yeah,
look,
they're
but
tall. They are tall
I know
guys.
that the banner that I have to go up with the arm if I pull up a banner. So these two guys are just huge. They're, by the way, his bodyguard, which I didn't know. No, I'm just kidding.
Really? I say, really? I know he's got a sponsor, but I didn't know the sponsor was that important. But there you go.
They just carry him from one tournament to the other.
There you go.
Yeah, and then we have something not too far away. It's Croatia, the Grand Chess Tour. And once again, we have Mr. Mamedyarov playing pretty well, of course. I mean, what do you expect from a top 10 or top 20 player? I think it's top 10 still, right?
Yeah, I mean, he struggled a bit in the right. He
Sure.
struggled a bit in the rapid, but of course, the important thing with this tournament is that Garry Kasparov is going to be playing the blitz section, right? That's the big standout. Garry, who has got Croatian dual, I think he's got dual
I
nationality now
didn't
with
know.
Croatia.
I didn't
Yes.
know.
He's either got full, I mean, he's got he, for sure they've adopted him in some way. So he has got something Croatian, so he'll be taking part in the blitz.
Absolutely. With
So
Ivan
and
Saric.
Saric,
And
yeah.
how the heck? 7 points.
Yeah, he's doing phenomenally. He's doing really,
What's
really
going
well.
on here?
Well, Ivan is a very, very good player. I mean, there's no doubt about it. I mean, Ivan is a top player.
But you would expect that he would be, but I mean, he's the lowest rated, right? So yeah, although he's very good, but
He's the lowest rated, but you know what? He's an insanely strong. He was 2700 for a very, very long period of time. He's got, great records against some really strong opponents, including Magnus Carlsen. So it doesn't surprise me at all that he's having a good tournament, especially in
That's
Rapid, where
interesting.
he's got a bit more of a chance, right? A bit of extra
I
chance.
like that. Oh God, everything is messed up here. I have to talk to the guys with the
Yeah.
server because
It's a bit.
Anand has changed dramatically, and he's also playing
Oh
for
yeah, that's
Poland. That is
yeah,
amazing.
that's not Vichy.
It's not Vichy,
That is
but
not
Vichy.
Vichy.
But besides that, Vichy's doing quite well. Also, seven
Yeah, Vichy's
points.
doing
I'm
well.
happy that Doing a great job. Also, a lot of fun to listen to Sagashar's commentary. I would all highly recommend to always take a look at the YouTube video. It's very nice and a lot to laugh about and very energetic. So yeah, that's gonna be over too in 2 days on Sunday, and then something else will start very soon, which is the no castling. We were talking about this too.
Yes.
And don't know. Yeah, here it is.
Here it is,
Vladimir and Viswanathan. So he's probably taking the Croatian tournament as a little bit of a training for this match too. But then again, is it training if it's no castling? Don't you mix the things up a little bit?
Well,
When he's like, just imagine he was going, he would castle, and then Kramnik would go like, this is no castling. Oh, yeah. Forgot. Sorry.
No, I mean, these guys know about this, and of course, there were a few things to point out that it's taking place during the Dortmund Chess Festival, which Vladimir Kramnik, I don't know if you know this, but he's got a very long relationship with the Dortmund Festival. In fact, I think he's played something like 20 times.
That is massive. Yeah, that I didn't know, but many, many times, yes. But
He's like the legend of Dortmund. He's known the organizers for years and years.
oh, cool.
Vichy has also, of course, played there for many years. And it's being supported by, this new format of no castling, with some collaboration with DeepMind, who, Demis is a good friend of mine, and it's great to see him, helping out and practicing this format, because it is an interesting format. It's a way to deviate away from too much theory. So it's going to be interesting to see, and they will be doing work on it. I mean, they're gonna want to win. I mean, they're still competitive.
Oh,
So,
no doubt about this. Yeah, we were talking about this too a couple of times already. If you're in the absolute top, like the top 20, there is a very, very big chance that you hate losing and that you are very competitive. Otherwise, you wouldn't get all this energy power to try to win a game. And yeah, this is another thing where even if it's just maybe to promote this game a bit, to have this Alpha Zero 2 part of it, it's they will try to win whatever it takes. I'm pretty sure about that. All in goodwill, of course.
I mean, it's going to be fun. There's not going to be too much pressure on them because, they've played, this is an exhibition match, and it will be just a very, very interesting match, and we'll see if
I think
this
so.
very we'll see if it gets popular.
To tell you the truth, I mean, we were talking about this, that there's like just almost an overdose of super tournaments. I'm welcoming this to see kind of a variation of the chess game with two of my childhood dream players battling it out. So yeah, I'm actually looking forward to take a look at this for a while and let the other tournaments do their d thing. It's still great, and there will be a couple of nice games every now and then. But yeah, I had a bit of an overdose, unfortunately. So
I
I will always
understand.
get back to this.
I do get it. I
What
really do.
next? There's so many things
Well,
this
there's a
week.
lot
It's
of things.
soon.
So the next thing I'd like to talk to, if you go up, sorry, if you go all up, is here, Pia Kramling
Yeah.
leading the Swedish Championship. So
There she
this is
is.
obviously, a great photo, first of all, of Pia. Pia, I've actually played Pia. I can't remember how I did, but I did play. I think she beat me, actually. Maybe it was a draw. Can't remember. Anyway,
Well, she's definitely a strong player, no doubt about
well,
that.
she's been the top, one of the top women players for decades now. And a strong grandmaster in her own right. She's very, what I would say, she's from the school of chess culture. She really understands chess. She's not a coffee house player. She's not a hacker. She understands the essence of chess. And she's played in the Swedish Championships for many, 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 many years. but she's never won it.
Mm-hmm.
And she's been over 2,500 before. She's rated 2,460 now, but she's been well over 2,500. Yeah. And for the first time, she's actually in the lead and with a chance of winning it. And she would be the first woman to win the actual Swedish championships in its history since 1917.
Go, Pia, please.
It would be great.
It would be so great. I can't tell you how nice it would be. By the way, to update you on the score, or you at home at the score.
Yes.
She got her fourth draw now and is at 4 points, exactly the same like Jung Min Seo, also having 4 points. So Jung Min Seo won his last game. Now they're both on the top. With 4 out of 6. So, yeah, difficult, but luckily enough, she won already against her greatest opponent at the moment. She beat him I saw it earlier. Let me check. There we go. Yeah. Let's take a quick look at the game, because I just saw that she won, but I didn't take
yeah,
a look
sure.
at the game. I'm not even sure if it's very interesting. So
let's have a look.
Let's fly.
I've not seen it, so I don't know.
So there's. Okay. So this is already. Is this a new normal move?
No, I mean, this is a move. Queen b3 or queen c2 is a kind of side variation of these Slavs. So they've all been played before. Yeah. And then we get a fairly standard. You know, castles, DC. Yeah, this is all fairly standard.
Taking with the queen. Okay. Yeah.
It's okay. We'll talk about that move if you all want, right. Just for 1 second.
Yes, please.
It's quite nice to take with the queen here. This is probably one of the reasons, because if you take with the bishop, if you go back, if you take with the bishop, black will go b5 here.
Yeah.
Right? And bishop b3.
I see.
Okay. And now he'll play either a6 or bishop b7. With the idea of trying to play c5 very quickly. That's what you want to do in these Moran structures. So taking with the queen is actually very sneaky.
Yeah,
because now b5, you can just take the pawn on c6.
Yeah, and that's trouble.
Probably. Yeah, I mean, it's still not completely clear, but it's something to consider. Yeah, it's something to consider. Okay. So that's why it's interesting. So now black has got some problems developing his position. Mm-hmm. Right.
Yeah, this bishop looks a bit dry on the c8 spot, as so often for black in many openings. In the modern openings, I see that the bishop on c8 is either advancing very late or just has trouble the whole game to get out of this grip.
Exactly.
So, yeah, that's an interesting move, of course.
So
it gets a bit more spicy here.
It got spice. So around here, so now the point is, after rook fd1, so white has given up the two bishops, but queen f5, queen c7.
Mm-hmm.
And white is saying, you can't move your pieces here as black. You just can't do anything.
The Zugzwang, make it much nicer, yeah.
To a certain extent, there's some kind of Zugzwang. Uh-huh. So black's move here makes a lot of sense. E5, trying to get the bishop out. E4, queen. But now after queen g6, you lose a pawn after knight takes e5. So you've sacrificed a pawn. Yes, you are able to get your pieces out. So knight f3, bishop g4. You're able to bring your pieces out, but you are a pawn down. Rook d5, nice move, hitting the queen.
Oh.
Queen g6, but now just knight d4, also completely fine. I mean, the position is still not that clear. I mean, black has got play here. Rook a1, b5, okay, a3. This will make sense.
I like black's position, to tell you the absolute truth, because there is some action going on the king's side. The bishops should be on the other side to give more power to this, but there are too many pieces. I mean, queen has kind of the advantage on the left side, if I can say this correctly as an amateur.
I mean, yes and no, basically. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's not. I mean, white has got a lot of, a lot of defenders as well. So it's not that easy.
Yeah, that's true. Okay, and there, now the position is getting a bit more secure. Again, mm-hmm. was that a double? Yeah, it was playing the same move twice in a row.
Mm-hmm.
And we're How much longer is it? Oh,
So it's a long game.
it is
I
a
mean,
long
keep
game.
on going. I mean, it gets
Yeah.
very complex. I mean, black does quite well just to kind of hang in there. But
Uh-huh.
now, yeah, now white seems to be taking over the initiative. F4. Okay. All right. Yeah, a lot of moving around, a lot of interesting stuff. But
Rearranging.
now with some pieces exchanged, this has helped white. E takes d5, and
Uh-huh.
now it's just a clear pawn. Rook d8, king f1, queen f5. Okay, rook d1 is good. Queen d3 is good.
Yeah,
Consolidating. Rook
trying
d2
to
is good.
oopsie.
No, everything is covered.
Yeah.
Everything is fine. Okay, so everything is fine. B4 fixing is nice. This is nice. And this is where, this phase of the game, if you just see how Pia has played the last 15 moves,
Yeah.
this is what she's really fantastic at.
Uh-huh.
She's not that great in the super messy positions, right? The super weird, wild, wacky positions. She's
Uh-huh.
good in these technical, I mean, she's of course good in those other positions, but where she's really good is in these technical, positions where she can push
And
slowly.
just convert, yeah.
Yeah, and just yeah, and now yeah, so she finds a
That's the
clean.
pawn, yeah.
Yeah, you well, it's still not over. Bishop g7 apparently is a
So
big
it's been,
mistake.
oh, yeah,
Yeah.
wait a second.
Now you win two pawns and it's now it's kind of
There's
no, because you win b5
one
as
is
well. So
going back,
you
yeah.
win b you win b5 at the right. D5, yeah, b5 at the right move.
B5, yeah. Yeah,
Yeah, exactly.
okay. Yeah,
Very
another
smooth,
chance to
very
attack.
nice. Yeah, and now 93, very nice. Rook a5.
Okay, and now
And
it's
then it's
just the
just a
end
tech,
game. Yeah,
yeah, it's just a
let's.
technical job now. Yeah, and
All right, okay,
when
yeah,
the
that's
bishops come
enough.
off, it's over. Yeah,
All
exactly.
right,
So, yeah.
and yeah, she has a daughter, a lovely daughter, Anna Kremling.
She does. Yeah, that's what I wanted to mention. Obviously, nowadays, when you hear the word Kremlin, it's
You
actually.
think about the Twitch star.
Yeah, her daughter, the Twitch star, who is a bit of a Twitch star, actually, if we're totally honest, isn't she? I mean, she's got a huge following. I think she's got an esports contract with an esports company. She's, she's building up her image, and in the really in the footsteps some of the other leading ladies, especially the Botta sisters. I
Exactly,
mean,
yeah.
they have done incredibly well in order to get. I mean, they really landed the jackpot with
That's
what they're
true.
doing.
That's a good management. And but the way how they've done it is also, I just believe Andrea is like a really smart girl. So she knew a lot what she was doing in many ways, so
Oh yeah, for sure.
Or am I mixing Alexandra? The older
Well, they're
one. I
both
think it's
smart
Andrea.
girls. They're both smart girls. But
So,
Alexandra's the older sister, but she was the
Alexandra,
brain.
I'm sorry, yeah, Alexandra,
Right.
I meant, yeah.
She was probably the brains behind all of it. But
Yeah. So, Pia, come on, you can do it, please. It would be really cool.
yeah.
I would be super happy about that. Yeah. Now, what else? We have. Let me quickly just get into this the new course from Nicolas Peart. He made a black repertoire versus the English.
Yes.
So all Italian football players should really take this course. This is interesting in a lot of ways, in my opinion, because first of all, I tell you a secret, I hate playing against C4.
Okay.
It's because it's one of those openings where I cannot make a play Gambi immediately.
Yeah, right. You can't force yourself, basically.
It's frustrating. So what I normally do is I play a tip that Mickey Adams gave. I play the bishop to immediately take the knight on c3, and yeah,
Oh,
I'm
right.
going from there. I actually won a couple of games with this system, so I'm pretty even
Okay.
against better players than myself. So this is working
Okay.
quite solid, but I just don't like to play it. I'm not having that much fun. Are you an English player yourself, or and do you like to play against English?
Yes, I started playing English quite late in my career.
Huh.
I've only started playing it in the past few years. I've got actually you know, I've got a pretty good score with it, I have to say. I play some slightly offbeat systems, like I'm not playing the super main lines.
Okay.
But the English is, it's an annoying opening for sure.
It is. It's, I mean, Richard, let me quickly dive into the live database. Rapport.
I'm just looking at my results with one C4.
Yeah.
They're pretty good. Should play it more.
Richard Rapport is he's playing the variation very often with the knight to f3 and g2 in the beginning, but he's always converting to c4, or not always, but often enough. And his score, I mean, he won in the beginning of this year, I think he won against a tournament against super top players like Ding Liren and Topalov and all those guys. And he played nothing else than c4. And I was like, looking at it, and I was like, what the heck is going on? And he just was browsing, yeah, through the games and won so many games with c4. It was, and this is, by the way, look at that one, g4. He plays this quite often.
I've played some stuff like this as well, by the way. I mean, it's a bit wacky. I would say don't try this too much at home
Don't
because
try this at home.
it can get a little bit out of hand. But yeah, I mean, it's an idea. It's a line.
Anyway, yeah, so super grandmasters even are playing c4 too much more often. I think Giri has tried it too a couple of times. You took over this later in your career, you soon grandmaster, so it is good to find a nice repertoire against it. And I've already booked it, the course to watch it on this weekend. I'm looking forward to this. And yeah, if anybody else struggles against English, maybe that's good. I don't know how it is yet, but I'm just believe like it's fun to listen to Nick's courses all the time, so I'm having a nice
For
time
sure.
with that. Yeah. Your turn, Lawrence. What else shall we talk about?
Well, I mean, if we go up,
Sure.
let's see here. Oh yeah, there was this the hearty chest gesture from the Czech Republic to the Indian state of Kerala.
I didn't read that.
Oh,
Can you
okay.
tell
So
us
this
about
was,
this?
yeah. So this was, I mean, I won't repeat the whole article, but
Sure.
basically, there's this chap who I've not actually met, I don't think, but his name is Pavel Matocha
Okay.
from Prague. And for years, he was organizing this chess train tournament where he would organize a tournament on one of these famous old railway. Old trains, the beautiful old trains, and he would organize a tournament on it, and the train would run for however many countries, and you would play a serious tournament on the train, okay?
Oh, cool.
And it was super
I think I heard of this.
beautiful, yeah. And he did this for years actually, and obviously since Corona, that's obviously stopped for the moment, but. In any case, he managed to organize a charity event where he managed to raise some funds for Kerala because, as you know, in India they're suffering a lot from
Yeah.
COVID. And he had a connection with one of the guys from Kerala, probably this guy Kumar, who I don't actually know him very well. And yeah, it's just a very nice gesture. He got the Czech number one, David Navara, to do a simultaneous
Oh, that was,
exhibition.
yeah, that was
Yeah, that
years
was
ago.
him. They raised something like €7,000, and that money was gonna be will be sent to Kerala to help with the efforts against
Awesome.
Corona. So that's a really nice, positive event. And there you can see. Well, this is Games on the Houseboat, so I guess this one is in India. So maybe that was an inspiration from the chess train to have a chess tournament on a
I
boat.
would get so
Would you?
sick.
Yeah, you would maybe on the boat. On the train, I would be
No,
quite interested in
train would,
playing.
yeah, that sounds great with the train. I mean, that actually looks very delicious on the boat as well. That, what a cool thing to have these special, interesting, and fun ideas to have a chess event on a train or a boat or something like this, Nitro Short.
Yeah, Nigel went
But
there. I mean, Nigel's been everywhere, but Nigel went there in 2017.
Oh, this is Kumar again.
Yeah.
Wow, okay.
And, you know, a lot of support. Read the article. It's a really nice article. Was the Prime Minister there? If you go up, hold on one second. No, member of the Czech Parliament.
There, Prime
Yeah.
Minister of Czech Republic. Oh, this is
Yeah,
him. Oh,
exactly.
wow.
Yeah,
Okay, I
yeah.
didn't know that.
Yeah, exactly. So it was, you
Huh.
know, it was a really
So he plays chess.
fantastic
Probably.
event
Big
to
thing. Yeah.
very, very. And there's
The
the train, yeah.
chess piece
I
on
would
the
love to
train.
play that tournament. Hopefully
How
one
do you
day.
get to into this tournament?
Well, yeah, I mean, it depends. I don't know what kind of chess train tournament they're going to do, if they're going to do an invite only. But yeah, I mean, it's a very, very long article, as
Yeah,
you can
my
see.
gosh, yes.
Insanely long article.
That's so
Like,
cool.
in beautiful, beautiful article. Go and read it.
Okay.
And well done to Sarah, the author, Saravanan, who obviously spent a lot of time writing this article. So,
Nice one. Very nice, yeah.
yeah.
What was the most so there's the chess train
Yeah.
tournament. Let me quickly ask, is there anything else? I think we're almost done here.
Yeah,
We've
we're
got
pretty much
yeah,
done for
I
this.
that is fine. There was a lot to cover, so we were browsing through a bit more than five, six, seven articles. Let me stop sharing and ask you the question. What was the most special tournament you've ever played? And by special, I mean like in a location which was beyond crazy or amazing. I would say like a chess tournament on a train was something to share because it is very special. Did you have something similar?
I haven't been to somewhere like I haven't had played a tournament in somewhere super kind of unusual. Like, I mean, I've played on the beach. I've played a blitz tournament on the beach. That doesn't really, I guess that's in Corsica. That was
Oh, that's
very nice.
super nice, yeah.
You know, playing in the mountains is nice and all of this stuff, but I've never played in Machu Picchu or, you know, on
Yeah.
top of Everest, or I've never played
Out
jumping out of a plane or anything like that. I've
of the
not played.
peak.
Yeah, exactly. I've never played anywhere super exotic. You know, lots of people do. I mean, when I think of ideas like that, I think of Timur Gareyev, who, you know, he's the sort of guy, you know, he jumped out the plane playing chess, and he's the sort of guy who's wacky enough to do something like that. But I'd be up for it. I mean, it depends on what and where, but I'd be up for it.
Yeah, I mean, I wonder why there's probably there are a lot. I just have to look for them. But I think this is the opportunity is there to have a chess game in the most wacky environments that they're possible. On an airplane is another thing I can imagine easily, actually. Maybe it's the wrong times to think about this too, but there would be like in nice airplane chess tournament in a
Absolutely. I mean,
747 or Airbus, a big one.
something like that, playing on a plane would
All
be
around the
cool.
world. Like you
Yeah, just go
fly
around the world.
around
Yeah.
the world for 7 days.
I can't imagine anything worse than just being on that plane playing chess.
You don't like to fly?
I don't mind it. I mean, I don't love it though. I mean, it's something that I've had phases where I've really not enjoyed it, and then
I
I'm
see.
just like, you know, if the plane goes down, so what,
If
whatever.
you fly too often, you go like, ugh, that
Yeah,
is
I
so
was
painful.
flying a lot before Corona in sort of 2018, 17, 18. I was flying a lot. I haven't been on a plane in 2 years, which is the longest time in my adult life.
It happens.
I don't mind not flying.
Yeah, I gotcha.
Yeah, maybe we could get like chess in space is really the one, right? Let's get Elon Musk, Virgin Atlantic, Richard Branson, all of these guys team up and play the f or on Mars. How about the
Chess
first
on
just
Mars.
yeah, the first chess tournament on Mars? That would be
Can
exciting.
you be the person who's inventing this and make the suggestion?
I'll make the pitch. I'll tweet at Elon. I think I've got an in to Elon. A friend of mine's got direct contact, so maybe I can just say, Elon, look, buddy, can I help organize the first chess tournament on Mars? That would actually be unbelievable. Get Magnus there, fly him out, you know?
And
say, look, buddy, we're on a different planet here, so your rating means nothing.
Exactly.
Your title means nothing. You're just a dude. You're just like anybody else. Start with zero.
Have you ever played against a Martian? Well,
Have you ever played against a Martian? Exactly. Yeah. He's going to show you what chess is about.
They have a different rule. They have double castling. So
yeah, exactly.
You can even castle back if you don't move the king and the rook. Okay, my friend. So, yeah, I'm really looking forward for the next week because we have a lot of interesting stuff coming up. Of course, Sochi and the no castling and all of these things. And yeah, it was a nice show. I hope you enjoyed it too at home. Thank you for your comments. It's always nice to read something like this. It gives us motivation. And yeah, I hope we can always entertain you and give you some insight about the chess news. Lawrence. See you soon, my friend.
Thanks, Arno. See you, buddy.